up, you guys? It's Adrienne. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another iPhone video. Big surprise there. iOS 12 obviously is the new software that's been out for a little while now, and I wanted to tell you guys about some of the best features and functions of iOS 12, as well as some of the hidden features that can absolutely change your life. So without further ado, if you aren't subscribed, subscribe, and let's get into it. By the way, it's election day, so I voted. I hope you voted. That's why I have the sticker on. Okay. So the first function that I'm sure you've already discovered, but if you haven't, it's called the Measure app. You can use the augmented reality software on your phone to be able to measure pretty much any surface or object in your house, in your life. It's pretty unreal. So all you do is open the Measure app, and here we have my camera. We're gonna measure this screen. So it says that's 2 inches by 4 inches. Let's go see if that's right. Got my little ruler. Wait, was that an inch? That was not correct. That's supposed to be 11 and a half inches. Let's put it down and, oh my gosh, that is pretty dang accurate. That's creepy. So that's obviously just a really cool function for anytime you really need to measure anything and you don't have a measuring tape or a ruler. I would be curious to see some of the interesting ways people are gonna use this app, but we won't go there. So the next thing is a new feature in Apple Music. I actually don't use Apple Music, I use Spotify because, I don't know, it's better. But we all know, like, if you hear a song come on the radio or, you know, in a restaurant and you don't know what it is, you use Shazam or Snapchat or anything like that to figure out what song it is. Well, have you ever had a song stuck in your head and you don't remember what song it is? So now you can actually search by lyrics on the Music app. So basically, oh, it's already reminding me. I like big butts. Oops, I can spell. In lyrics. And then here comes the song, Baby Got Back. That's cool. You can do this even without a subscription to Apple Music, which is nice. So if you use Spotify like me, but you still wanna like use this function, you can. So that's really cool. So the next feature that you guys have probably noticed on iOS 12 is notification grouping, which is so, so, so nice. Cause I don't know about you, but I get so many notifications and it's so nice to be able to group everything together, like all the text together, all the emails, everything like that. So something that you can now do that you weren't always able to do, well, first of all, they never had grouping. They did a long time ago, I think in iOS 9, and then they got rid of it, which was really annoying. So now they have it, which is awesome, and you can customize all the settings you want in the notification settings section. But you can also 3D touch on a grouping, and then if you push this 3 dots in the upper right-hand corner, these 3 dots, I know grammar. So they call this instant tuning, where you can now basically change the notification preferences right from your home screen rather than having to go into the settings and change it there. And then if you choose to deliver quietly, that means that future notifications will not appear on the lock screen, present banners, or make a sound, but they'll still show up in your notification center and as a badge app icon. So that's pretty cool. And then you can also click deliver prominently to have them go back to normal. If you do choose the quiet mode, you can go back to normal. You can also turn them off completely by clicking that. That'll just turn off all notifications for that app. And you can also click on settings, which will just take you to the actual settings section. So the next little hack is having to do with Siri and how much Siri has improved. So Siri actually gives you guys some shortcuts that I didn't even realize were available. So if you go to your settings and type in Siri and then click Siri and search, basically, you'll see this little page that says my shortcuts. It'll also say suggested shortcuts. So basically, it'll like ask you if you want to add shortcuts for things that you do quite often. For example, if I text my friends Haley and Lauren often, if I push this plus, it'll basically have me record what I want to say when I want it to do that. So let's say I was like, text Haley and Lauren. So now when I say text Haley and Lauren, it'll do it. So let's just test that out. Hey Siri, text Haley and Lauren. It works. You can also see what other shortcuts Siri suggests by clicking see all, and it'll basically look at all the apps you use and what you use regularly. It'll kind of get to know your routines, which is a little bit creepy, but also really cool, I think. You can also add your own custom shortcuts by downloading the Shortcuts app, which has a bunch of different shortcuts you can use. I don't use a ton of these personally because a lot of the apps that they line up with, I don't use very much, and like the apps that I use, they don't have shortcuts for. If you click on Gallery, they have shortcuts for all these different things, which is so cool, like play a playlist. So you could basically use Siri to be like, hey, play my playlist. But again, like it only uses music and I use Spotify, so that one I can't really do. But they have a bunch of really cool things. Laundry timer, like you can set this as a shortcut and it'll like remind you when you need to go get your laundry. So you would just be like, hey Siri, remind me when my laundry's done. And you can set like the time and all that. Send yourself an email containing all of today's meeting information. Like that's cool. So basically if you make any of those, so I made one for share availability. So what this means is if I say, hey Siri, share my availability. It'll basically prompt me to choose a date, and then it'll look at my calendar, see when I'm busy on that day, and then devise a text that says when I'm free to someone. So let's say I was gonna say tomorrow. You would go like that. And then let's say I wanted to message it to my mom. It would literally tell her when I'm free based on my calendar. So that's like pretty cool. While we're on the topic of Siri, another thing Siri can now do is tell you your passwords from your iCloud keychain and all of your stored passwords. So instead of having to go digging for one, if you like don't know it and you're trying to get on your computer or something, all you have to do is say, hey Siri, show me my Gmail password. It'll do FaceID. And then I'm not gonna obviously open this, but it'll show you all your passwords. So that's pretty cool. The next little hack and trick is in the Photos app, there is now a tab that says For You. And this tab not only suggests when you should maybe share photos with someone who's in the photo, or it'll also suggest like editing things you should do on certain photos. So for example, it says sharing suggestions, share with Lauren. And that's because like we took a bunch of pictures and they recognize it's Lauren, which is super cool. Just nice and convenient. They also suggest like certain ways that I should edit some things. So it'll say like, this one says brighten this portrait photo with studio lighting. I don't want to because it's an ugly picture anyway, but I just think that's kind of cool. Or this one will be like, do you want to loop this? Okay, the next one eliminates a lot of problems for people that don't love Face ID or have trouble getting into their phone through Face ID. So actually, any phone with Face ID now allows you to have another face stored under Face ID. I don't know if anyone knew that, but basically, if you ran into issues before, it was likely because you had sunglasses on or a hat and things like that. So basically, your iPhone now allows you to have a second, like, alternate appearance. So if we go to settings and type alternate, go to Face ID, it says that I can set up an alternate appearance. So I could do that, like, with sunglasses on. Hold on. We're gonna do it with these sunglasses because I wear these a lot and they never freaking open my phone. So, here we go. All right, so let's see if that works now. You didn't see because I stopped recording, but it worked. The next little trick and hack is really for those little studious intellectual nerds out there like me who get really frustrated that all that Apple has is a dictionary versus a thesaurus. So in the past, if you highlighted a word and said, look up, it would only show you the dictionary definition. Now it allows you to actually click and find some thesaurus alternate words that you could use instead of that word. So that's just kind of a neat little handy trick. The next hack is that you guys can actually add student IDs to your Apple Wallet. I know, which is super cool. I mean, it doesn't mean that you shouldn't have a physical copy of a student ID, obviously you always should, but I think it's really neat the fact that you can add it to a wallet so that when you get discounts at stores or if you're paying with your ID or whatever, you can actually just have it right there on your phone. That would eliminate a lot of the $15 lost fines that I got. Cause I kept losing my student ID in college and we would get charged $15 every time. So that was stupid. This would have really come in handy back then, but whatever, it's fine. Next, I'm gonna show you how you can edit photos and put stickers on photos in the Messages app. So right from Messages, if you go to take a photo, ooh, that's a rough photo, but you can actually click effects. And then if you click on the filter thing, you can like do all these wonky little, ooh, that's kind of cool. Look at my eyelash. You can also put text. Yo, arrows or whatever other shapes you want. Target has stickers. That's kind of cool. Anyway, you get the point. There are a lot of different things that you can do right from here. You would just click done. And last but not least, screen time. You guys have probably heard of this. This one actually really can change your life because you can just stay so much more focused on the present and things that you're doing, not on your phone. I don't know about you, but sometimes I'm just on my phone so much it actually exhausts and disgusts me and I hate it. So this is super nice that you can actually use this to really monitor your own self, I guess. So if you go to screen time, you can schedule time away from your screen, which you can set custom times. You can have app limits where you can basically tell yourself like, okay, I can only be on this app for an hour a day. So then when your time runs out, you literally can't access the app, which I think is really cool. Of course, you can always like take it off, which is dumb, but I feel like you wouldn't go through the effort because you'd remember that you aren't supposed to. Like today, I spent an hour and 12 minutes on social networking. That's not that bad, actually. Not that bad. But let's see the last seven. The fact that in the last week I spent 7 hours on Instagram, that's actually sad. That's really sad. Anyway, You can set apps that you want to allow at all times, and you can obviously block any content, but I don't know why you would unless you have a kid, then definitely do that. So I just think that's like really cool. It just helps you to be more productive, and I think that Apple knows that we are way too addicted to our devices, so it's kind of cool. Well, those are my 12 hacks for iOS 12. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope they change your life. Let me know down below what you think, what your favorite one is, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. See you later.